All right, we rolling. I forgot my fucking gloves. Yep. You gotta come out and teach the word in the rain, sleet, hail, and snow. Hey, I think it's a nice evening though. It was a perfect, it was a beautiful evening. Look, this guy's going out for an evening jog. Say, Esau even training in the rain. So, but you got these homosexual Israelites. They only teach in the sunny weather. Well, you need a hand? Oh shit! This shit getting wet. Ah, fuck. Hold on, I got white. Camera got wet. We gotta get a waterproof camera, like one of them underwater cameras. Are they waterproof?
Hell yeah, you gotta surf them with them on your surf.
Oh hell no, we need one of them. That shit, do they stream straight to the internet too, don't they?
Yeah, cause I think the commercial they got the people swimming with.
Oh hell no, I got to have one of them. This, I don't even need this damn umbrella. Or I can hold the umbrella for you. Or...
That's what Rihanna said.
Rihanna.
Stand under my umbrella.
Is that a song?
Yeah.
I don't fucking.
Oh, what the fuck? Goddamn midgets using this shit. Oh, this. Can you take my glove off?
Oh,
I got a coffee in one hand, fucking umbrella under my arm.
Give me the camera.
I gotta adjust that
strap. What's the word for ambidextric or
ambidextric?
Ambidextric.
I don't know if people ever use the strap. Is that too loose?
The fuck ass police. Over there get some donuts. They turn on their sirens so they get some donuts and coffee real quick. Yeah. It's an emergency. We low on coffee. I don't blame them though, shit, I need coffee. Shit. If I was a cop, I'd get free coffee too. But I would never be a cop, because only faggots are cops. I'm a bitch ass fucking faggot.
I do it all the time, man. Like the brain blink, it just blinks out.
Oh, I got one to start.
Lights go off.
Revelation 2 and 10. Revelation 2 and 10. Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. Yeah, so fuck the police. They're the devil. They'll throw your ass in prison.
Yeah, I'm right. Those sides whooping stick.
Yeah.
Most of these motherfuckers need to be thrown in prison.
You know, thank God for some of them cops, though.
These motherfuckers are ruthless.
Imagine that shit.
Motherfucker kill their own mom.
I actually believe if there was no cops, there would actually be no crime. Because the only thing stopping us from putting 2/3 to death is the cops.
It's the cops.
Think about it. If there's no cops, if there was a child molester, the whole neighborhood would get together and kill his ass.
That's right.
They'd have public executions, hanging. Hey man, it'd be a perfect sunny day.
Shit, back in the old Wild Wild West, you have a shoot down at noon.
You go round up a posse and you go kill every goddamn buddy. The people, the cops ain't never saved me. They ain't never saved nobody.
Gave us a bunch of fines.
They only show up to ask questions if you saw it go down.
Ask questions, write a ticket.
Yeah, write a ticket, draw the chalk line, just to search your shit. The fucking police, man.
It's Psalm 17:13. Arise, O Yahweh, disappoint him, cast him down, deliver my soul from the wicked.
Yeah, deliver us. Oh, I'm sorry. That's what we be saying. Yeah, deliver our soul from the wicked.
Yeah, that's that wicked stick. That's the Most High, the devil, the wicked stick. That's the
truth. Yep. Right, because, yeah, the Most High created the police.
Right. Oh, they tell you, though, motherfucker argue with you. The devil, who's the devil? White man ain't the devil. They argue with that shit, man. They argue with you. Police, they do righteous acts, man.
Yeah, they on that faggot shit. You be listening to Alex Jones, he be on that faggot shit.
Oh, you hear about Alex Jones, the dude protecting him got killed yesterday?
Yeah, I heard that.
Assassin. Oh,
man, you know that's some bullshit.
Yeah, I'm kind of skeptical on it, though.
Ain't no,
they try to say a hitman was out to kill Alex Jones.
He never know, though.
He could be sending the death angel after that motherfucker.
He probably would.
And he going to get him eventually, you know? He going to get him eventually.
So. We'd throw a party like when Michael Jackson died.
Right, get drunk as fuck. I got drunk as fuck, man, when Michael died, man.
Oh, man.
When Whitney Houston died, I got drunk.
Whitney.
Oh, you hear Ricky Henderson died today?
The comedian?
Ricky Henderson.
Baseball player?
Oh, Ricky Henderson. Baseball. Oh, damn. Man.
He died of a massive heart attack.
Yeah, probably all them,
52.
Yeah.
Probably all them steroids dudes take.
Mm-hmm. Eating bad. Probably it's probably that time of year.
Oh, Peyton Manning just got busted for steroids.
All them athletes are on steroids.
James Harrison, there's allegations coming out on him, too, now. Just came out today. Who? Allegations.
Who's that?
Pittsburgh linebacker. Yeah, Most High going after these motherfuckers, man. Just like your boy that hyped the prices of the drugs and shit.
He's goner.
Yeah, they went and arrested his ass.
Damn.
All kind of. I was reading that last week, wasn't it?
They need their AIDS medicine.
Yeah, they went after his ass for corruption, man. All these motherfuckers, the United States is some righteous shit, doing shit the right way.
Hell no.
They're a lawful nation? Since when?
That's why everybody think Donald Trump gonna save the universe.
make America great again?
I didn't know it was ever great to begin with.
Yeah, he gonna make America great. Oh, under Ronald Reagan it was.
Under Reagan. They wasn't.
What they,
they wasn't saying that back when Ronald Reagan was president,
yeah,
was it?
Yeah.
New World Order founder.
Because Ronald Reagan wasn't running shit. That was George Bush running that.
Yep.
Because he tried to do something, and then they tried to assassinate his ass. And after they tried to assassinate Reagan, man, he ain't never go against the Illuminati after that ever again.
Yeah, that's right.
Because that was George Bush Sr. running them two presidencies.
They went after his ass too.
George Bush Sr. was in the White House for 3 terms. Then actually, the Clintons and Bushes, they're good friends. So really, they're all the same family.
All the same shit.
Obama.
All the same shit.
Yeah, Obama, they're all related.
That's some funny shit. Man.
It's been one continuous, it's like royalty.
It's just like if I owned a restaurant, my family would take over, not your family.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Kings. Yeah, the busser, the dude who done worked at a restaurant for 30 years, he ain't gonna become the new supervisor.
He ain't gonna be the CEO,
hell
president.
No. The whoever owns the restaurant, his son.
That's right.
Oh, just like the White Castle. I seen the White Castle president just resign.
Damn.
And the employee of the month didn't get the job. His kids got it. His daughter got it. So that's the president the same way.
Only a fool would have been looking forward to this. Only a fucking fool, man. Only a goddamn fool. Damn,
he's like, I'm gonna bust my ass this year and I'm gonna get employee of the year and I'm gonna become the new CEO.
Right.
It's like that movie Coming to America. He went in there first to start off on the fries, then you might move up to the lettuce. You know how that shit went?
Right.
Talking about a dead end job.
Right. Talking about retarded. Oh, man. Oh, that was the comedian dude.
That was your dude from Good Times, wasn't it? Good Times owned the restaurant. You know your boy from
the father. But yeah. The white
James Earl Jones.
Was the dude who said that.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, the fat dude.
Yeah, he was a comedian. He was a funny motherfucker too. He was a funny motherfucker. That's how they are too, man. They look forward to that shit. Bust they ass for nothing. They don't know, bro. You can't tell them nothing. You can't tell them. These bitches working, especially on this holiday season, 60, 70, 80, 90 hours a week. Hopefully when the New Year's come in and shit, they gonna get promoted.
And then notice this, too. I be going up in restaurants, Walmart, all these stores. You see bitches with tattoos all over their titties.
You see motherfuckers with purple hair, blue hair, pink, looking like some freaks. But try to get a job with a beard, and they will not hire you. You can look crazy as hell. Tattoos on your face, they'll hire you. But if you got a beard, you ain't getting a job. Yeah, you got that big one, them bugs, the ear plugs.
You in ISIS? You trying to help fund ISIS?
Yeah, but, oh yeah, if you got a beard, you're part of ISIS. There's some faggot shit out here, man. Oh yeah, you try to get a job at a restaurant. If you got a beard, they'll say you gotta shave it, but they got women with long hair working everywhere, getting all kind of hair up in the food.
Don't even have it bundled up.
They got fags working there. They got jizz all over themselves.
Yeah, they got fags serving you. Yeah, got fucking butt juice and shit on their fingers. You know what I'm saying? Well, touching finger in your plate.
Mustache.
Yeah, a mustache. A mustache is some weirdo shit, man.
They'll tell you the mustache. She got to.
That's all goes back to the manliness. They don't want men to be men. Because you notice beards is getting popular. More and more, you see more and more athletes wearing beards now. Especially you see the NBA, a lot of dudes got their beards out. Because a lot of them dudes, they know about the truth.
A lot of men can't grow beards too.
Oh, it's a trend though, you're right. Hey, what'd you say?
A lot of men can't grow beards.
Oh, I mean, if you can't grow, ain't no big deal. I see your dude Joe Biggs had his beard out.
The dude from Limp Bizkit was rocking a beard for a minute.
Limp Bizkit?
Fred Durst.
Fred Durst. He's a big douchebag.
Oh yeah, he's a fucking weirdo all the way.
He's a weirdo all the way.
I seen one of their concerts they did last year. Fucking weird.
Right here.
Where'd you get that?
That's why I didn't want to say that. I was hoping that Gloom was going to have it when I called him to order it, man.
Get that on camera. Can you get that on camera? Get the Hebrew. Wow, this book looks interesting.
Oh, man, my back's already fucking up.
Yeah, it should get wet.
I got to find my fucking glasses.
Oh, I got that one book to my son. They took it home. I didn't get it back yet.
What?
Where'd you find out about that?
I'm
gonna get a scripture.
Fuck, come on.
Hey, I still got the book and all that shit to that camera.
Oh man, I'm confused like a motherfucker without it.
What camera?
I'm stuck.
I got the box and everything. I sold him that camera.
Spy camera?
No, the Sony.
Oh, you gave him the camera?
Yeah, he bought it.
Oh,
shit. I never use it.
All right, go ahead. You guys, I was about to break. Go ahead.
Psalm 17:13. Arise, O Yahweh. Disappoint him, cast him down, deliver my soul from the wicked, which is thy sword.
Yeah, the wicked is the Lord's sword. Because the Lord created the good and the evil. I got a precept because the Lord, because people like, that don't make no sense. I got a precept for that. This is one of them days. I got a precept for that. If I can find it. Matthew 18. Matthew 18:7. Woe unto the world because of offenses, for it must needs be that offensive come. Because the Lord created good and evil. Woe unto the world because of offenses, but it must needs be that offenses come. But woe to that man by whom the offense cometh. Right? Even though the police, the Lord set them up, the Lord still said woe unto them. You know what I mean?
That's right.
What's that scripture? Deceive and deceive your sins.
Job. Yeah. Hold on a second. Yeah,
That's my Bible getting soaked. Let me keep going. I'm gonna keep going.
You want to read it again, man?
Want to read that again?
Yeah, you might as well, man.
Matthew 18:7. Woe unto the world because of offenses. For it must needs be that offenses come, but woe unto that man by whom the offense cometh. Yeah, because even though the Lord set these devils up, still woe unto them, man. They still gonna get destroyed.
They always say, what kind of God is that? What kind of God is that?
Yeah, they would let. Like, if God is so loving, why would he let murderers and child molestation happen? Right. He said woe unto them. But he said that the offenses gotta come.
Is it unrighteous with the Most High?
Nah.
Lord forbid.
Here you go. This is Matthew's 12 and 34. O generation of vipers, how can ye being evil speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart the mouth speaketh. A good man out of the good treasures of the heart bringeth forth good things.
Hey, this is really talking about all these fake ass preachers and prophets and Bible teachers teaching all this bullshit. Keep going.
Teaching madness.
Teaching madness.
Bringing forth good things. And an evil man out of the evil treasure bringeth forth evil things. But I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment.
Yes, all that. If you teaching a bunch of bullshit, you're going to be held accountable for it. You out there teaching all this madness, saying Jesus love everybody, he's going to save everybody. God loves faggots. You know what I'm saying? Teaching it's okay to have faggot preachers. You teaching it okay, it's okay for all this weird shit to go down.
You teaching Most High loves the sinner, but hates the sin. Where the fuck they teach, man?
Teaching that all nations can be saved.
Right.
All that bullshit, you'll be destroyed.
This is the most accurate horoscope ever.
A horoscope?
Read it.
The stars and planets will not affect your life in any way.
Yeah. It says that for every, like, Aries, Taurus, all of them, all the way down the list.
37. For by thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be condemned.
Oh, when you, like, IUIC, and you say the name of the Most High is Yoplait Yogurt, and you say the name of the Lord don't matter, you can just call the Lord Christ. You're going to be held accountable for that. A university. Yeah. That's madness.
A university. Just to get vaporized.
It's all about to get, they're trying to get paid. They ain't going to get, fuck them assholes. I hope someone burns down a university. You know, it ain't going to be a university. That shit going to be raggedy as hell.
Right.
Rapping and shit, just rap all fucking day.
Rapping?
That video I kind of like. It's like half of the dudes rapping and girls singing and shit.
Oh, sounds like.
ISU.
Yeah.
That shit's corny as hell. I've seen one of their rap videos before. That shit was terrible.
It was awful, man.
It was horrible.
You should have seen the one with the Soul Train line and shit.
Got no skills.
Soul Train line, it's all kind of shit. Burgers and fringes.
Burgers and fringes.
Burgers and fucking fringes.
That don't even
man, it goes on and on, man. Man. Burgers and fringes.
Were they flipping burgers and their fringes?
Yeah, it was a cookout.
You're not even really supposed to eat hamburgers.
It has fat in it.
Yep. You're not supposed to eat fat.
Not supposed to eat cheeseburgers, definitely.
Yep. Well, yeah, because there's a scripture that says you're not supposed to cook the mother in her kid's milk. So when you put, you know, the cheese on the burger, that's kind of going off, man.
Cheeseburger.
But if you got
cheese. Ain't that kind of disturbing a little bit?
What if you got cheese on your chicken sandwich? Is that acceptable?
Oh, a cheese God. On chicken?
Oh, that's mixing animals.
You can't mix animals. Yeah.
Oh, you can't have mayonnaise on your chicken either.
Oh, you see? See, people act pretend like they keep the law perfectly. You ain't keeping shit.
Mayonnaise is made out of the eggs from the babies.
And all this food got all kind of fucked up shit. It got soy in it, genetically modified soy, genetically modified corn. What's it called? No, go ahead. Because you got these assholes, they think they keep the law perfect. Yeah, it does. It's got jellyfish in it.
No, they got natural sour cream that does it.
You can find some good stuff.
Yeah, but probably the popular shit probably
got it. Yeah, all the popular shit all got gelatin.
Oh, no doubt. All the chip dip has gelatin.
That's why I stopped eating it. They put it in that 99-cent cheese. Don't ever buy that.
Burning the cheese and it wouldn't even burn. It didn't melt. That ain't even cheese.
Yeah.
I seen this bitch eating a prison bologna sandwich the other day. Oh my god.
Oh man, that's foul.
I can imagine that.
Bologna? You don't even know what's in bologna. Nuts and ears and snouts.
Them motherfuckers ain't got shit to eat. They eat it.
Another article came out the other day that 90% of the food got human shit in it.
Oh yeah.
You seen that one?
I didn't see it, but I believe it. I've heard it before.
And that goes perfectly with the book of Ezekiel. We don't eat shit.
That goes with that saying, eat shit and die.
They said Issachar was shitting all over the spinach and shit.
Oh my goodness.
Just hoping that we got
food. Oh, they piss on the fucking produce.
If it's going to America, man, I, you know.
They be like, fuck your spinach.
El Chapo ordered that shit.
I can imagine what's done. You know?
They do that, man. What do you think? When I was a high school teacher, my teacher, I forget his name, he played for our Ohio State basketball team. I forget this dude's name. But he knew people that worked in factories, and he said the dude worked at the bologna factory, and he'd be pissing right up in the bologna batter. And then bologna's
funny.
Huh?
They probably just thought it was funny.
Yeah, they think it's funny.
Yeah. It is funny. I don't eat that shit.
My brothers do that shit at the restaurant, that popular restaurant, Ryan's, pissing in the Kool-Aid. You know?
Probably jerking off in it.
He would tell you every day, man, to speak about shit he's doing, man. I don't even know them places no more, man. It's very rare, I think, man. I might go to Chipotle's or some shit.
They just got a bit.
Yeah, they had E. coli going through all their shit.
They still do. They're still huge. I ain't been in a minute, though.
Probably Chipotle's from their distributor.
Motherfuckers ain't feeding the cows grass. They feeding them corn and grain. That's fucking up the cows.
Yeah. Well, they feeding that. Yeah. Remember, like a year ago, there was a story that he was feeding cows candy because it was cheaper.
Yeah. And
they expired candy.
Expired candy. So these people who claim they're keeping the law perfectly, you're eating fucking tainted beef. The cows are shot up with all kind of antibiotics and all kind of crazy shit. They're fucking genetically mutated.
They feed them petroleum pellets.
The milk that you get from the store is all fucked up. Got all kind of chemicals in it.
Milk? Pus milk?
Yeah, pus milk. It has pus in the milk.
Yeah, that's because they're shooting them steroids in the animals and they're overproducing.
Yep.
They're overworking and it's working and they ain't got time to fucking heal. Because, you know, bodybuilders lifting weights, especially the ones that's on steroids, they rest a lot. There ain't no motherfucking cow or whatever they shooting up resting.
They don't give them no rest.
They just constantly, that's fucked up, man.
It's like a factory.
Yeah, that's fucked up, man. That's sad, ain't it? That's some sad shit, man. If you can't feel for an animal, man, a helpless animal, man, that the Most High put the fear in to fear you, or the fear of Israelites, I don't know about them other nations. They fear the other nations because they just vicious-ass heathens. You know, they feel their spirit. They read their spirit, man. But Israelite, you see them attacks on YouTube. You don't see them animals attacking Israelites, man. Lion attacks, snake bites. Yep. Or what the fuck have you know?
Usually some heathens getting jacked up.
Yep. Some new shit just went up the other day on some lions eating at some East Indians.
Oh, that reminds you of David and the lion's den.
Right.
I said David. Daniel. Daniel and the lion's den.
We was acting like...
up, man.
We didn't even correct you. He's going along with it.
That's fucked up, though.
My hands messed up. I'm serious. Go ahead.
Psalms 104 and 14. He causes the grass to grow for the cattle.
There you go.
Oh, yeah, and there's different types of grasses, too. Like, the regular grass that is in your front yard, and shit, cows can eat that shit.
Mm-hmm.
But we can't eat it. But we can eat other grass, like wheat grass. You know that. You know your bread comes from grass. It's just a different type of grass. Rye is a grass. You know what I'm saying?
You notice a dog gets sick. What does he do? First thing he do, go outside.
Same with the cat.
Yeah, they start chewing on the grass.
He's sniffing around for a certain grass.
Yep.
You know, he be sniffing around for it too.
Every time, yep. And then he chew a little grass and he starts puking. Then he eats his own puke.
That's fucked up, man.
And you then know, goes the licking other buttholes.
They're going to get their revenge on Esau too in the kingdom, man. You know? They're going to get their revenge on Esau too in the kingdom. Other nations too.
Even the trees will get their revenge.
You know? That's fucked up.
That's Isaiah, bro.
Check it out, man. You know, what's it called? FC, what is it? There's some shit that Prince Charles got started. Not Charles, but what's the one the ugly old woman married to?
The FDA?
What is it? FCC?
FDA is the Food and Drug Administration.
No, it's the F, something that has something to do with animals. I can't remember the acronym on it, but anyway, it was started because it was organized to, because it started the land grant.
Talking about the Duke of Edinburgh.
Chris, the one that said he wanted to come back as a pirate.
Prince Philip.
Yeah, well, anyway, after they started this charity fund thing, that's when a lot of the land in Africa started getting sucked up. And you know them, they're called, you know, a lot of them lands is labeled at a reserve park or some shit like that. Anyway, ever since Prince Philip started this fundraiser, the decline of all the animals started. They were going over there slaughtering the motherfuckers on a crazy level. You know what I'm saying? Like the rhinos, the lions, the elephants.
Oh, they still do that shit.
You ever notice that a poacher, they kill them now. You know, ever since he started this shit, man. He started back in the 70s, early 70s, late 60s, early 70s. I'm gonna have to find that actually go down. I might have to do my bag, man. These some devils, man. They, you know, they push that shit that save the animals, because there's certain ones becoming extinct. That's called some motherfucker. I mean, you
they
know.
They kill, they hunt.
They hunt them.
Just like that dude that got caught with that Cecil the Lion.
Yeah, another dude got caught killing a rhino, a rare rhino, right after that.
That's fucked up.
You know, that's because some Edomites pay $50,000, $100,000 to go specialize. That's what they do. Go specifically look for something to kill, man. And you know Esau ain't working. That motherfucker out destroying shit, man, on his vacation. Prince fucking Phillips.
He looks fucking evil as hell.
What the fuck is that acronym on? It's popular as fuck, too.
It's not Yusuf or...
No.
World Heritage or...
I might have... Let me look for it a minute.
Talk about animal rights.
That's what it was started for. That's what the charity was started for, animal rights. Helping animals that's going extinct. That's because they're killing the motherfuckers. They're locking that land up for themselves, man.
You're not talking about PETA, are you?
Nah, that too. That was probably started to put some weird bestiality.
Man, my Bible's getting fucked up.
I heard it, man. I'm holding something up. Some motherfucking devils, man. Some deceitful devils, man. You know the devil ain't gonna start anything and he having some righteous deed in mind. Or he have a righteous act in mind. That's impossible. Give me one devil that started something for a positive reason.
I know that. I didn't catch the real time. I was trying to get it, but I just soaked my whole page.
Oh, damn.
This Bible seems worse, though, so.
Let me read this real quick. This is Proverbs 12 and 10. A righteous man regardeth the life of his beast.
Oh, there you go.
But the tender mercies of the wicked are cruel.
Yeah, because that tells you this is not a righteous kingdom. Look at the way they treat the animals. Look at the way they raise chickens. If you've seen the videos of how they process chickens and make chicken nuggets, you will never eat chicken nuggets again.
Won't eat them again.
Oh, I haven't since I have.
I showed my son the video, he started crying.
I mean, it's disturbing, man. This shit's literally disturbing.
It is disturbing.
What do you expect from a devil, man?
What about the spider chickens? Those are real.
Spider chicken, yep.
They grow chickens with eight wings.
Then they got spider goats, spider chickens. There's some weird shit going on, man.
They probably got Spider-Man walking around somewhere.
Shit, they probably got a real Jurassic Park somewhere.
Yep, you know they do. You know they do.
You know they're real Jurassic Park.
You know they do.
They have to.
You know they do. This guy, I mean, ain't no perfect shit that they probably recreating. A T-Rex probably come back with one leg or... You know, a T-Rex probably be a fag. Shit. You know he's doing that. It's a place over there in an island off on the East Coast. I can't remember what the name of it is, though. It's a little freaky place, a geomastic. L is talking about all the time.
Not Jekyll Island. That's where the Federal Reserve shit went down.
Oh, man.
I know what you're talking about, too. It's off the East Coast.
There's an actual island over there that they refer to it as a... Jekyll, they refer to it as some shit like that movie. What's that movie with?
Island of Dr. Moreau.
Right, they refer to it as something like that, yeah.
Yeah.
And wait till the time comes when the motherfucker, whatever is in there, comes out, man. Because it's eventually going to come out.
Resident Evil.
Yeah.
Yeah, Resident Evil. Oh,
yep.
Resident Evil games, they show you how Esau operates. They show you in those games that like some real rich elite aristocrats are behind the scenes running all this shit and they're like super sadistic. Worshippers of death, and they just love killing people and releasing the viruses just for fun.
Experiments and shit. That's probably their sexual thing they get off on. Seeing crazy shit men doing.
And you see, the symbol of umbrella from Resident Evil, what's that? It's the symbol of that Knights Templar symbol.
Hey.
That cross, that, you know what I'm saying? Cross?
Yeah.
You see that everywhere.
Fucking
dumb. Go back to that Freemason shit. There's a lot of truth in the Resident Evil series.
That's some bad shit. That's some bad shit.
I smells like fucking swine out here. You smell that shit?
I gotta see the second part of that movie you told me about. The first one covered a lot of that, how society's gonna be controlled and this and that, but that second, I can't wait to see the second one, though. I can't find it, though.
What's that?
Man.
Yeah,
sir.
I'm gonna find a video store or some shit. You know, fucking faggot ass torn sites and all that shit.
Pirate Bay work.
I can't get it to work.
PirateBay.LA.
I don't want it, but it don't.
You got a torrent downloaded?
You gotta drag and drop it. You can't just. Sometimes you can't.
Magnet link?
You can't just click on the magnet, it won't work sometimes. What operating system are you using? The Windows?
Hell no, you know I'm fucking
out of the I have to see it, man. I can get it working for you.
Oh, man. I wish this fucking rain would stop.
That Windows 10 is garbage, man. I had Windows 10 on my computer just for my son and certain apps. My shit is already broke. It don't even work. This is garbage. It's fucking... It is horrible. Every time I use Windows 10, I just be cussing. Oh, I hate Windows.
Goddamn devil.
I can't find that scripture in Isaiah. What's that scripture in Isaiah 14? It says the trees will rejoice. The cedars, I think it says.
Oh, I can't take it.
I got it on. Isaiah 15.
Oh, it's 15?
Yeah, I got it. You want to read it?
Yeah, read it.
15 to 7. The whole earth is at rest and it's quiet.
Oh, yeah, so when the kingdom comes, this is going to be the deal right here. Read that.
Oh, shit. Hold on. The whole earth is at rest and quiet. They break forth and sing. Yay. The fir trees rejoice at thee, and the cedars of Lebanon saying, since thou art laid down, no feller is come up against us.
Yeah, so even the trees are going to rejoice. Oh, that's right. There was a study in the news that came out and said, there was a scientific study came out. We could have already told you this, but it said trees have memories. They can remember, and they have feelings.
Yeah.
and plants. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It was just in the news this week.
That's crazy.
They said that the plants have memories and they can feel.
Yeah, the best of growth is they say they leave music on for them.
Yeah, leave music. Talk to your plants.
Mm-hmm. Leave the TV on for them or whatever.
Yeah, at least this TV. That really works. They've done test after test.
They say if you play Bach to your plants, that it helps them grow a lot more beautiful. Some Bach.
Bach, Sebastian Bach.
Who's that?
Johann Sebastian Bach. That classical composer. You know Bach.
I'm right here.
It's the greatest shit ever.
You know I love something.
I kind of like it. I don't know, not so much sometimes.
I love that shit, man. I mean, just have it on low.
I fall asleep with that classical symphonies and shit on.
I don't like, it's just like any genre of music. I like some of it I can't stand.
There's an actual page on YouTube, I can't find it anymore. They play another classical shit. Well, actually, it's the one Tahoran we use when we download the music.
I'll be,
they have music playing.
Listen to music choice.
I like some jazz. I never really got into jazz. That must be something you like when you get older.
Some pleasant stuff, man.
Yeah, some chilled out shit.
No, just some people's spirit can deal with it, man.
Yeah. Cause I get tired of hearing all those words. I just want to hear instrumental.
Mm-hmm. Turn it down low, let it play.
Yep.
I ain't been in the spirit for music in months, man. It's been literally months, man.
Yeah.
I can't get no good. I ain't had no good sleep in fucking 3 weeks. Literally, man. Everything aching, hurting.
I feel you. I'm sick.
Something waking you up.
Like up in Earth.
Yeah, because she got the store I got to me too. It's like way down there.
The German Village?
Nah.
High Street?
Yeah, way down there.
Okay. Past Hudson?
I think so. But, you know what I'm saying? So Earth.
This would be the fucking day for the tripod.
I can't find a leg.
You have to scoot with that store, man.
I know there's one on Cassidy and Beckley.
Earth store.
That's probably harder to get to, dude. Yeah, it's an organic store. They got everything.
Do some spells.
Yeah, I think it's like, I think I'm type of herb. You go sleep better. Like lavender.
Lavender. I use lavender to keep away the mosquitoes. I'm sure it got a lot of uses. Yeah, honey. Yeah, you know honey can kill all kind of bacteria. You know they actually did find honey in an ancient Egyptian tomb. It was still good.
Damn. What?
Honey does not, as long as you keep it with a lid on it.
Damn.
Honey does not go bad.
You know vegans don't eat honey.
Really?
Because it comes from the bees.
Honey is the nectar of the gods.
Yeah, honey's a good shit.
They said the Roman ancient royalty, that's all they would never give it to the mortal people. No. They would keep it all to themselves, man. Honey. Honey's bad, man.
That's some good stuff.
Hell yeah. Pure honey. Unrefined honey, man. Virgin honey, too. Ooh. There's a big difference.
Man. Great, all the bees are dying out, too, ain't it?
Right. Esau got all them plants, all them bee colonies.
Oh,
you
damn.
Know, the honey, Esau has all that.
Fucking my back up.
Will you hold that umbrella for you?
We are totally reliant.
That's gonna help.
He wants us to be totally under control.
Yeah.
Only the Most High can do that power. Only he can do it. He got us totally dependent on the devil for everything, all want and need. God damn, it's crazy. The motherfucker is comfortable. They got a strong case of that what they call captured bonding.
What?
The mother captured bonding. The same thing as Stockholm syndrome. Captured bonding.
Oh, captured bonding. Yeah.
Under your capture so long, you actually start to love that motherfucker and feel compassion for the bastard.
That's how these fools are out here.
Yep. Captured bonding.
These people is dumb as hell. You tell people that they're slaves, they're like, I'm not a slave. I'm free. I can go anywhere I want. Okay, let me see you go anywhere you want without the proper papers. Be
you don't have your papers. Let me see your papers. They'll pull your ass over. Right. See what happens if you ain't got proper papers.
Just like that faggot ass Farrakhan said that he the only free man in America, but he was didn't take that money, that $1 million from Gaddafi when he offered it to him. Faggot.
Man, he got millions. Farrakhan got millions.
Big money, man.
He could have been just set some shit up.
Big money, man. Oh, he got his own shit.
He got his shit.
Yeah, his shit. He got that land out on the West Coast, out in Arizona.
And look at all the worms on the sidewalk.
He lives good. Worms will start raining from the sky. There's worms everywhere.
Yeah, I noticed that earlier, man.
We be stepping and squishing them and shit.
Worms stinking and stepping on them.
Yeah. Talking about Esau killing all the wildlife, we kill them worms.
Hey, man. Don't mean to do it. It's actually Esau's fault. He's the one that built all these goddamn sidewalks everywhere. Hard ass turned the whole goddamn city into a desert wasteland made out of concrete.
That's crazy.
That can't be good for the earth.
Dang.
He gonna just pave, get rid of all the dirt and soil, put concrete over top of it. What the fuck is that? Yeah, this is a living hell, man. If they had their way, they would turn the whole planet into a metropolis. It'd be like that planet off of Star Wars, where the whole planet was a city. If Esau had his way, that's what he would do.
The whole planet was a city. Dang.
Turn the whole planet into concrete, covered it. You know what I'm saying? They would do it if they had the chance.
Something huge about to come. Something's coming. Don't forget about that Russian plane that set down. They got shot down.
Russia ain't forgot about that.
Something huge is stirring up, man.
Russia's being smart about it.
Got their intelligence in there, man, to Turkey. Something big gonna come.
Because they was hoping Russia was gonna bite on that right away. You know, they did that on purpose. They tempted them.
Yeah, the Russian reports came out and said Turkey did come out and said they.
Dude, you ain't fucking with Russia, man. Anglo's a faggot.
That's crazy. Something that's brewing up big. I bet the first day of 2016 will come out like a bang. I'm excited for the 31st. I want to see what the fuck they gonna sign this year.
Oh, they gonna sign something.
A new law gonna come in.
I done given up hope that they gonna blow up Times Square.
Oh, man.
That ain't never gonna happen. I wish it would.
There'll be millions of people down there at that one time, don't
Yeah,
at that one time, man. Hope a building collapsing or some shit.
Because you think they would have been jihaded that motherfucker. You know what I'm saying?
Right. I hope so, man. I hope I'm not disappointed.
That tells you a lot of that jihad shit is fake.
It's a beautiful spot. I think that's the spot we was at when Paul called the comedian dude that magician to the flag.
David Blaine.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, David.
Remember that Times Square?
David Blaine is a big weirdo, man.
That was right when that shit in Haiti happened.
Oh, yeah, the flood. He looked like David Blaine. He looked like a heathen up close, didn't he?
Oh, yeah.
He is weird.
Yeah, but he
is a fucking weirdo.
Yeah,
that's why I cursed him out. I wouldn't have done it if he had a cool spirit.
Right.
Nah, that dude was a weirdo.
Yeah, he was weird.
He was into that Satan
shit. That motherfucker was a real magician. Yeah, goddamn warlock.
A deceiver.
Power from the left hand side.
Yeah.
Yep.
He probably know all kind of witchcraft.
He does it on TV.
Hey, what's your name? What's your dude? Houdini. You know Houdini was a so-called Jew?
Damn, what?
Yeah. Come on, man. You know everybody's a fucking so-called Jew. Anybody who was...
Houdini?
Anyone who they say is the greatest is a so-called Jew.
Yeah, the greatest. And he died doing the trick, didn't he?
Actually, he died from someone punching him in the stomach.
Oh, what?
Because a little kid.
Oh, he didn't get caught in some
or a student. Nah, that almost killed him. He actually died by, he used to get, people a challenge by punch me as hard as you can in my stomach. And he didn't tense up right or something. The kid punched him too fast and ended up killing him.
Wow.
But I would just say he was a magician. That's something, you know, so-called dude is a master sorcerer, a master deceiver. You know what I'm saying?
That's all.
Yeah, they fucking think of wicked plots to deceive people all day.
Just like Hollywood. Hollywood really means the Hollywood. The Hollywood is the magic wand. Magic wands are made out of the holly. It was literally made from Hollywood.
Did anybody see yesterday or today, Alan Jones talking about Hollywood?
Yeah. He's breaking it down good?
I didn't stop to listen to it. I just heard him mention it a little bit or something.
I remember years ago, Alex Jones made a video where he said Arabs ran Hollywood.
Oh, fuck. He was going on.
That's a good one.
Whose ass he pulled that out of?
I don't know, man. They ain't never let him forget about that one either, boy.
Wow.
You can't let no, you can't even forget.
Damn, that bus is fucking packed today.
That bitch was wheel all up on the curb and everything.
Yes. Usually that bitch is packed.
Yeah.
That's because of the weather. Oh, motherfuckers ain't working and shit this weekend.
Why not? It's busiest time of the year.
Oh, that Christmas bullshit.
Oh, they on school break, ain't they?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
fucking should have hit Parsons.
Ha, Parsons. Yeah, somewhere. Fuck it, man. We out here. The word ain't going out, boy.
That's right, folks. Many motherfuckers going by your cars, they see it.
Good. It's our presence alone out here.
Shit. You know?
There ain't no mistake in seeing people wearing this. They know something going on. And a lot of people already know who we are.
Crazy motherfuckers out there wearing dresses.
Oh, man.
That's what they be saying. Crazy motherfuckers wearing dresses.
Your dude over there, he's been over there for like an hour. He listening.
Right.
You wanna talk about he got headphones on.
On him not to come over here and ask questions.
I can
give a fuck if you
don't. Yeah, I don't give a fuck either. It don't matter if anybody's fools believe or not.
If we're doing what we're supposed to do, that's all I'm saying.
Yeah, the truth does not require people to believe. Just because you don't believe that just because you believe that the sun creates light. Yeah, it doesn't, you know what I'm saying, it doesn't change the fact that the sun makes light.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's a dumbass analogy, but... Yeah, I got a scripture for that. But you got something? Go ahead.
Here it is. It's 21. This is 1 Corinthians 1 and 21. For after that, in the wisdom of the Most High, the world by wisdom knew not the Most High. It pleased the Most High by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe.
Yeah. It is foolish. Yeah, because people think we speak in foolishness. When they retarded as hell.
Retarded as fuck.
Man, these people don't know shit about nothing. They don't know shit from apple butter. What's that?
Apple butter, right.
Yeah.
This can look like shit.
Hey, eat it all day.
Got a question in their mind. What's in this? Same thing with these people in these lightning. It's pulling people in off the streets under their fucking false philosophies and shit. But people ain't foolish enough to question the people. Same thing with these fools going to the grocery store. They ain't question shit that's in it, the ingredients.
Oh, hell no.
You know, they just eat it. They just consume that shit.
You tell someone about GMOs, they don't. So, it's good.
Right.
It tastes good. Don't eat pork, that shit's real bad for you.
Right.
It tastes so good. I mean, I got the mind of a retard. The mind of
a child.
It's like more less worse than a child. It's like it's like a mind of like a retarded Down syndrome freak.
Like Yeah.
You ever watch that movie?
Yeah.
The average people, they remind me, you ever watch
That movie with, man.
Anderson Bergeron.
That's a good movie. Bergeron, Harrison Bergeron. Yeah, that's a good movie. Watch Harrison Bergeron. Wasn't that movie with Dan Aykroyd had Tupac in it? With the one with a Digital Underground in it? Had Demi Moore in it? It had Dan Aykroyd, it was in it. He had a dick penis for a nose.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
Remember Bobo and Little Devil? The little fat, retarded dude? That's like your average person out here. He's just fat, just sloppy, just dumb, just retarded, just eating and being all sloppy and shit, just sloppy and stinking. Motherfuckers are just like, they're like sloths. What's the word? I'm not even...
They just willing to do anything and everything.
They will do any and everything, you know, man. Then you got like big fat 300-pound faggots. Fuck, how fucking disgusting is that?
Fat faggots.
A big fat faggot.
Fat faggot is probably more attractive to them. A fat faggot.
We see them all the time.
Hey, my neighbor, man, I saw three different motherfuckers parking cars down the street to walk in his crib.
Oh, shit.
And this was like over a three, 4 hour period, man. And you know, he a faggot. He a big time faggot, man.
All kind of diseases up in there.
Mm-hmm. And he got a, hey, the faggot making money, man. He the only one staying in that big ass house, that nice ass car he got.
Yeah, faggots always got money. What's up with that?
Right. And when if you walk by his crib, he might have a window open, his living room window. He got a big ass TV in that bitch, man. Flat screen, man. It's a big one. A big old faggot, man. Got it going on, man.
Yeah, this is a faggot. In America, if you're a faggot, you'll be successful.
Be very successful.
Because there's like a faggot underground. It's not even underground, it's like open now. If you're a faggot, you get favors, you get promotions, you get raises.
Find friends.
You get bonuses, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You could be the hardest worker, it don't matter, but if you're a faggot, you get promoted.
Mm-hmm. You get special attention.
You get special attention. Cause this is some, man, this is some weirdo shit we living in. You got something, bring it out.
Second is a spot and none. And salt water shall be found in the creek, and all friends shall destroy one another. Then shall wit hide itself, and understanding withdraw itself into a secret chamber.
Oh yeah, understanding has withdrew itself from these people. It is hiding. Yeah, because it really is.
Because you ever notice a motherfucker come up and you know you can't teach him shit?
You already know.
Oh, I don't even try to.
The spirit shuts down itself.
Yeah, the spirit shuts down.
Don't want you saying shit.
You can tell right away, and then you just don't even want to go any further with it.
Back in my younger days, I would have tried my hardest to teach him. But now I'm like...
Working against the grain.
Yeah, pissing against the wind.
Right.
But now I just know if somebody can get it or not.
Mm-hmm, yep,
just after, yep. You might hit them with one little... As soon as they were
Where's homie from last week?
It's raining.
Did he ever call you?
No, I didn't expect to. I'm going to call him, bro.
You can't expect people to go out teaching in the rain,
right.
That'd be crazy.
It's hard enough. You're coming up around them motherfucking false-ass preachers, false-ass prophets, man. They ain't teaching you shit, man. They see us out here, it's still a shock to them.
Yeah.
You know, they even give you compliments. I see y'all out here representing them.
But they don't even get it, though.
Right.
They don't even get a lot of people, they don't even know what the truth is all about.
Right.
They don't even get it. Go ahead, bring that truth out.
You had a good spirit on him, though.
Most people
give him time, though. You know?
Yeah.
We'll give him time on him.
You can tell he ain't all the way right.
He ain't gonna give him to the day of destruction.
He said he had papers written in Hebrew that he was going to show the judge.
Hey, can't blame him for that, though. You gotta blame the fools that brought it to him.
Yeah.
You know?
Because that sounds good.
Hey, he fell for it, though.
It sounds good.
Right.
You're like, you almost made me want to give me some papers. Like, I can get my Hebrew papers.
Right, yeah, you can't be mad at him.
That's something Peraza was probably passing around.
That's probably what it was.
Because, man, there's some bugged out There's some bugged out teachers out there, man.
Do we? I mean, come on. When did we stop being under these motherfucking curses and we can write papers and shit?
Man, he had a magical tablet he was going to pull out in front of the judge.
Yeah, I seen somebody go to the courtroom. I think it was a Moor. And they tried to go in the courtroom pulling out that sovereign shit, saying, I'm sovereign. You know what the judge said? Oh, you're sovereign, huh? You and what army? That's what makes you sovereign.
That army.
Is an army.
That's right, arms.
If you ain't got an army, you have no sovereignty.
Raising up arms. You got to raise, you got to pick up them arms.
Right, and who has the biggest army?
That's right.
Well, right now, you
Satan.
Know, yeah, Satan.
You know?
The army of the dead.
North took up arms army against of the darkness. South. I mean, that's coming back, though.
Oh, it is. They're trying to bring it. Yeah.
It's coming back. Hey, Most High must be mad at Texas.
Oh, they got fucked up.
You see that?
Texas, they
Texas
a bunch of...
getting fucked up, man.
They deserve to get fucked
they
up.
They getting fucked up. God damn, a tornadoes on this time of the year?
Texas that's always think they great, the freest state.
Of all places, Texas, man.
And y'all motherfuckers are not free in Texas.
That movie coming out on... Amerirac?
Oh, yeah?
Something like that. It's only going to be released in Texas.
Oh, really?
What's it's going to be covering martial law and some shit that Alex Jones and his people putting together. I can't wait to see it, though, because a lot of brothers is talking about
you
it.
You know, Ohio actually has more lax gun laws than Texas.
Damn.
Texas ain't the freest state. That's that bullshit they put out there. That's that propaganda.
Floods everywhere, man. Floods, California. You see the fire that burnt the cars up, motherfuckers trying to drive through the fire?
Oh, shit.
Dumbasses.
I seen that bitch, that black bitch run some motherfuckers over in Las Vegas.
You see that? Oh, yeah, man. Fucked them up, man.
She did it with her baby in the car and everything.
She said she did it on purpose.
Didn't have no reason to do it. She just did it.
That's some spirit.
That's some spirit, man.
That's a spirit.
I was laughing my ass off because that Sunday we was on that shit talking about bitches and they driving and this.
Man, these bitches can't drive to begin with. You know, when I heard the article, I already know who did it before you even told me.
Yeah.
I think I asked you. I was like, was it?
That was some funny shit.
Because you the one that told me about it. And I looked it up.
Looking all stupid in court and shit. Looking stupid as fuck. I guess she must have thought Obama was going to save her ass.
Obama?
Oh. Yeah.
He's going to pay your rent, going to take care of your babies.
Yeah, he's going to pay your attorney fees.
Obama's going to do it all.
Yeah, that's beautiful, though, man.
So what are they going to do when Obama's not the president no more?
We may not get that far.
They're going to look for a new savior.
By that time, Michelle probably run for senator.
Oh, shit.
You know what I'm saying?
Michelle went by a landslide.
Yeah.
Because all the women voting, Michelle win it.
Yeah, because they're going to take total.
Oh, yeah, votes totally count.
Well, you know what I'm saying.
Yeah, of course, votes count. She's not going to lay it down. He's not. He's going to be in the scene still after he was president.
If we even make it that far. Yeah. But who would win? The Lord willing, just fucking, they start shooting missiles soon.
Man, I'm praying.
But who would win in a battle between Michelle Obama and Donald Trump?
Oh, Michelle, clean it up. Clean it up.
You know, the Simpsons said that Donald Trump became president like years ago.
Yeah.
And the Simpsons predicted all kind of shit. They predicted 9/11.
You know what? If we do get that far, I would prefer to see a clown like him in it.
That would put people way back to sleep. That give them the chance to bring the chip and everything in.
That'd be interesting, though.
They should have Dave Chappelle as president.
That could start the Civil War right there. You don't know what could do it.
Oh, yeah.
Then the country becomes so divided between right and left that the motherfuckers start succeeding.
Dave Chappelle gonna watch this. He gonna run for president now.
Oh, when he
run
for black president.
If Dave Chappelle ran, that's how stupid this country is. Dave Chappelle will win.
You're like, I'm rich, bitch.
Yeah, I'm rich, bitch. He already had it on his show. He was the black George Bush. Yeah.
Richard Pryor did it a long time ago, too. And he had a scandal when he was president. Richard Pryor was president. He was fucking too many white women. It was a big scandal. But it's a funny shit.
I got some precepts for that scripture. You got more than that? You got to read that.
Yeah. It shall be sought of many, and yet not found.
Oh, yes, so read it from the top again.
Then shall wit hide itself and understanding withdraw itself into a secret chamber.
So wit to hide, you know, because we're witty. We come up, man, we quick thinkers. Boy, you can't come up here talking those slick shit.
You know?
Because, you know, we way slicker than you.
I heard this shit 1,000 times.
Yeah, exactly. We already got pre-programmed answers for your ass. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, a lot of people are, like, by the numbers. Because their questions...
Like, that's a man-made book.
Yeah, their questions are so unoriginal.
Yeah.
Like, no, we never heard that before, dude. So, yeah, we already got a lot of pre-planned answers.
Like the Book of Enoch.
Yeah, booking all this dumb shit. Go ahead.
The tablets.
It shall be found.
The emerald tablets.
It shall be sought of many, and yet not be found. Yet not be found.
Oh, because you do got a lot of people searching for wisdom, but they find the wrong wisdom. They were searching for truth, they find David Icke.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Be all fucked up, believing in reptilians.
You should have seen this new shit of niggas on the internet saying that the aliens are all Negroes with bald heads and
damn,
you know, and
yeah, I've heard
and,
that.
And they're actually the Anunnaki.
Oh, they're the Anunnaki.
Yeah,
I thought it was the tall whites.
Right.
You heard the tall whites.
Yeah, yeah.
Then
yeah,
you got the reptilians, yeah, the tall whites.
Tall blonde whites.
The tall blonde whites.
Yep. Just bugged out shit.
Yeah, it's a bug. I've heard. Yeah,
the truth is far.
The Nephilim.
Truth is far more fascinating.
It is. The truth is way. And you know, it's way more believable and provable.
Right. But they gotta add shit to their all them Babylonian deities to this shit. You know? That's all it is, all that stuff that they teach is all Babylonianism.
It all, really all Babylonianism. Yep. Right. It's gotta sound real, it's gotta be all fantastical.
Who was that? Stitching guy. Stitching.
Zacharias Stitches.
Yeah, that was, he was a expert.
Zacharias.
Is that the dude of Kuvrik Kaneo for him?
Oh, he's a so-called Jew. Yeah. Amalek.
Rat Jew. Rat.
I'm ready. We got drunk on the day he died, I believe.
Sure did.
Oh, he's happy.
Stitching, yeah.
Old ass bastard.
Before he died, he was sick as fuck. And I remember the first heart attack he had. I was laughing, man.
Cause that old bastard did know a lot of shit, but
a lot of shit, yeah. Yeah.
Jordan Maxwell's homie.
But all he was doing was going back into that old Babylonian.
Yeah,
shit.
He kept going to old Babylonian shit.
Yep. Fucking Zacharias Sitchin.
Man, that's their top guy.
Yep.
I mean, Zacharias Sitchin, and this motherfucker is like, he's like the master historian for these fucking weirdos.
Sure was. With an annoying sound to his voice, too.
He made all the weirdo books.
Sure did.
All the Anunnaki shit.
Man. Sure did. He almost got hit.
Zachariah Sitchin. That fucking weirdo. You got all these faggots out there. Graham Hancock's.
They eat that shit up, man. But shit, the
right. They eat the shit.
What about your dude, Bubble Eye Blackfish, with the tubes up his ass?
That dude, no, that's a Prophet Yahweh.
Oh, he back on the scene again.
Prophet Yahweh?
Yeah, he got a new video channel. Yeah, new channel.
He's sticking tubes up his ass still.
I'd watch Prophet Yahweh.
I finally saw that video too, like about a month ago.
I seen it when it first came out back in like
4 or 5 video series.
Yeah, back in 07.
Mm-hmm.
I actually seen Prophet Yahweh before I found Great Millstone.
Yeah, sure did.
I think I got sick when I first seen that video, right?
But yeah, they had video. He was on the news and he was summoning UFOs out of the sky.
Yeah.
I don't know what the fuck he was doing.
Before I found GMS, I found Nate, his short video.
I never see his ass.
Prophet Yahweh and Comfy.
Yeah, because the first time I ever heard anybody say the angels were black was Prophet Yahweh.
Prophet Yahweh, yeah.
He said that.
Yeah. I found him on the Edge. I found him on the Edge Radio. The Edge is the Edge Radio talk show is like 610 at AM. What's his name? George Norrie and all that.
Yeah.
He's the same type of shit.
Okay.
Same type of shit. George, the Edge.
I probably have heard
internet radio.
That's all I listen to is radio. Yeah,
it's been around since as long as I can remember that.
You hear that?
What is that?
Huh?
Is that thunder?
That jet.
Oh,
jet. Hope it's a military jet.
I seen a bunch of military helicopters flying around a couple of days ago.
Man, there was thunder at my house the other day. It lasted for like 2 minutes. It was just like shaking the whole house like it was an earthquake.
Yeah, it was some powerful thunder a couple of days ago.
Yeah, lightning too. Yeah. You finish with that up?
Oh, this is a good part here. It said, then shall unrighteousness and conducity, I don't know what that said, be multiplied upon earth. One land also shall ask another and say, is righteousness that maketh a man righteous gone through thee? And it shall say, no.
Oh, shit.
There's no righteousness out here. Very little.
Very little, yep. That's cool. Yeah, that's us.
Very little. You can't trust, everybody knows you can't trust nobody. That's why everybody leaves, they locks their doors. It's the first thing when they do when they go inside their house, they lock the door right behind them.
Yeah, you don't just leave money laying around in your own house
hell
either.
No, you don't. You got friends over? Hell no. You, even if your brothers and sisters coming over, motherfuckers hiding their shit.
Man, I remember going to Chillicothe and Newark and Zanesville, those little small towns and shit. And I remember, man, I still remember like it was yesterday, how people would leave their car keys in their car. They would leave all night long, the front door, back door be open.
Yeah.
The free, you know,
oh, yeah, my sister, she lives out in Delaware. She leaves her key in her car.
Delaware, too.
That's
crazy. I should have mentioned that, man. I should have mentioned Delaware. She can't do that now, though.
Hell no.
She does.
Still does?
Yeah.
Well, somebody gonna
I mean, it's inside of her garage lock, yeah, but...
Well, I do that. If I put the car in the garage, I'll leave the keys in there.
Not me, my dumb ass will lock them in there.
See, I'll put the windows down. I'll leave the windows down. You got more of that out?
Nah.
Here you go. 2 Ezra 12 and 37. I'm 36. 35. This is the dream that thou sawest, and these are the interpretations. Thou only hast been meet to know this secret of the highest. Therefore write all these things that thou hast seen in a book and hide them. And teach them to the wise of the people. I got some tissues up.
I got some already used.
They just hurt my fucking nose.
Whose hearts thou knowest may comprehend and keep thy precepts. You know, just another thing, man. You just, these people that, you can just tell motherfuckers you can't teach, man. So, yeah, we be up here throwing precepts at them, clowning on them. They don't understand what the fuck you're talking about. Our precept jokes, you know how we do it.
Yeah.
And have them stuck on stupid, man. Just have them stuck on stupid parable. I meant parable, not precept.
Oh, hit them with a parable?
Yeah.
These people are nobody.
And they relate what they can't relate whatsoever, man.
Yeah, you just say you can't put wine in old bags.
They don't understand shit.
Fucking work. I was eating bread, and I eat bread every day for lunch. And dude was like, the Bible says you can't live on bread alone.
Yeah, right.
They think that's serious too. That's dumb, man.
I was like, did you read right below that?
These people are so gone.
They are gone, man. They are gone. Just as they should be.
They're right. They should be. You're right, though. You know?
So, my blood pressure's not going to get up.
Up
to 140, 150, 160. Mad at these motherfuckers.
Shit, it's a good time to me. It gives me something to laugh at.
Yeah, you gotta accept it, man.
Yes.
Acceptance is the answer.
I think it's beautiful. And how they get mad that this book is simple, man. It's simple to understand, especially if you got a Bible dictionary, you got an etymology dictionary. It's simple. And they probably mad at us because we understand this simple stuff and they can't understand it. You know? They can't comprehend it at all, man.
I got a scripture. Proverbs 21 and 2. Every way of a man is right in his own eyes, but the Lord pondereth the hearts. You know what I'm saying? These fools, they wicked as hell, but they think everything, it's all right with what they do. These whores think it's okay. She's like, well, you know what I'm saying? I'm in a new relationship now.
In our old relationship,
that's old, you know.
Oh, I was reading Christ's genealogy today. And it had, you know how Solomon took somebody else's wife or something?
David, you mean?
Yeah, David. It said his wife was the former wife of the dude she was with. It says his name in the genealogy, the former wife.
Even David sinned, so.
No, but that's in the first chapter of Matthew.
Yeah.
You know?
We keep going with this
stuff.
Oh, you got something there?
No, go ahead. You got it. I'm actually trying to find this one.
Well, I wanted to read all this up to this one spot. I'm just read it all until I get to it. To do justice and judgment is more acceptable to the Lord than sacrifice. A high look and a proud heart and a plowing of the wicked is sin. All these people got that proud look. They walk around things like, you know, can't nobody fuck with them. The thoughts of the diligent
tend only to plenteousness, but everyone that is hasty only to want. The getting of treasures by a lying tongue is vanity tossed to and fro of them to seek death. I mean, that's getting treasure. That's all these people care about is getting money.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Get money.
Yeah, fuck. We laying up spiritual treasure.
Getting
money.
Paid. Getting paid.
Treasure, you know?
Yeah.
Physical shit. Shit that rust and shit, you know, fall apart.
Exactly. Even gold and silver is worth it.
Yep.
They get it because paper is not money. The robbery of the wicked shall destroy them because they refuse to do judgment. The way of a man is forward and strange, but as for the pure, his work is right. It is better, check this one out. It is better to dwell in a corner of the housetop than with a brawling woman in a wide house.
Wow.
It's better, it's like better to be with one of these loudmouth bitches. It's better just to sleep on the roof.
Wow.
That's a good one.
Hey, it's some wicked people, man.
That's a good one right there.
Some wicked ass bitches, man.
The soul of the wicked desireth evil. His neighbor findeth no favor in his eyes. I'm trying to find a scripture.
Hey, my daughter, my wife made me so mad the other day. I was about to make everybody homeless, man. I swear to God, man.
About to burn the bitch
just
down?
Just furious, man. I was just about to, you know? It was getting hard to control myself, man. I was going to punch both of them bitches, man. I was about to fuck the whole house
you
up.
You should have, it's better for you to get on the roof.
You know? You know, that's what I did. I just go
you went to the roof?
Get on the roof.
That's
the
guy I remember that one. Man, alone, away from everyone.
It's better to dwell in a corner of the housetop than with a brawling woman in a wide house.
Shit, the Lord had to, I mean, these people are simple, man. The Lord had to get away from the 12 apostles at times.
Oh, yeah, he would go by himself.
You know, right.
By the rivers of Babylon.
He was out by himself fasting in the wilderness.
I can't remember what the, I looked up soldier, the etymology of soldier, man.
The word soldier?
Well, solidary.
Solidary,
there you go.
And it also,
let me look it up.
There's multiple meanings behind that word.
Yeah, let me look it up anyway.
You know, the soldiers also got paid a solidus. Anytime you see that word soul, that go back to son, too. The soul, and hey, you notice the word soul means one, and solo, one. Just like the word soul means son, there's only one son. So you know they got paid the solidus.
Solstice.
The solstice. Well, yeah. That's what Christmas is all about. The winter solstice.
Yeah. Can you somebody spell soul?
Soul? S-O-L? S-O-L? Soul dire. Soul dire, the one who dies for the sun. Let me read this.
Soul dire.
Got it.
S-O-L. It's not S-O-L.
I'm a soldier.
Yeah, soul dire. It's
soldier.
Really spelled soul dire.
Okay, spell it.
S-O-L-D-I-E-R.
Soldier, right. That's it.
Soul dire. They die for soul invictus. They die for the sun god.
Soldier. Soldier related to soldier, soldiering, to soldier, to persist, doggedly, and attest his shoulder. From old French soldier, one who serves in honor to pay, from maybe the Latin soldarius, a soldier, source of that Spanish, whatever. Literally, one having paid, from late Latin soldier, soldum, extends sense of accusation of Latin, some name of Roman god coin, thus being regular in the English
coin,
myth,
the solidus.
Latin, witty, and Joe, always soldier, blood, it seems to mirror, spelling, whatever, is borrowed from the Latin, and many military terms picked up during the Italian. Which is one old slang means military.
That's got a long history behind soldier.
Oh my God, it's going on and on, my man.
But you know, the word soldier in the Bible is actually a Greek word. You can come where you get the word strategy. Strategos or something like that. Can you look the Greek word up? The soldier is really a Latin word, and the Bible is written in Greek. Well, the New Testament's written in Greek, not Latin. Let me read this while you're getting it. I'm going to finish this up. Proverbs 21:11. When a scorner is punished, the simple is made wise, and when the wise is instructed, he receiveth knowledge. The righteous man wisely considered the house of the wicked, but God overthrow the wicked for their wickedness. Whoso stoppeth his ears at the cry of the poor, he also shall cry himself, but not be heard. A gift in secret pacifies anger, and a reward in the bosom of strong wrath. Oh, this is the scripture I was looking for right here. Let me read this. Well, this coming up. Proverbs 21 and 15. It is joy to the just to do judgment, but destruction shall be to the workers of iniquity. The man that wandereth out of the way of understanding shall remain in the congregation of the dead. Let me read it again. I messed it up. I can't talk. The man that wandereth out of the way of understanding shall remain in the congregation of the dead. So that's why all these fools out here, they're like the walking dead, man. They got no understanding.
Zombies floating.
They're really zombies. They're fucking gone. They got no brain, no mind. They just walk around.
Some motherfuckers, they look at you crazy like they don't. You can't teach them shit. Like they know everything, man.
Yeah, you can't teach. They already know everything, but right. They don't know nothing.
Don't know nothing.
They don't know shit.
They know how to suck a cock.
Yeah, yeah. Well, they're looking to suck a cock.
They want one.
You know, they're looking to suck one.
They want to take down a 12-inch rod.
I mean, this society is really all about sex worship. I mean, even the Washington Monument is a sexual magic symbol. It represents Osiris's penis. This, if we look around, there's probably penis fucking symbols everywhere.
Yeah.
It's symbol shit, like Disney Channel.
Disney Channel. Oh yeah, the Little Mermaid got dicks in the background. They got the bishop on Little Mermaid, one of the preachers. He got a dick sticking out. You seen that Mickey Mouse cartoon with Mickey Mouse at the Swiss cheese factory? He was putting holes in the cheese with his dick.
That's crazy, man.
Those are all phallic symbols lit up right there. They look like penises.
They probably are phallic symbols. You can't see the Leveque Tower from here. A lot of buildings are built that look like penises.
That guy's a penis.
And if any man thinks that he knoweth anything, he knoweth nothing yet as he ought to know.
Yeah, because you got a lot of people that, yeah, I know the Bible. Then you ask him basic questions like, who the Lord come for? Jesus came to save the whole world. He came to save the whole world.
What about John 3:16?
Yeah, yeah, they get happy when you ask him that. They're like, oh, this is my favorite part. Like, Jesus loves everybody. He came to save the whole world.
That's right.
Somebody actually said that to me a couple days ago.
He's like, he came
ago.
To take away sin from the whole world.
So why is the world still sin?
Man, I was listening to the Bible radio up on the way up here.
You got pulled over.
Oh, that was, yeah, that's what happens when you listen to Bible radio. You get pulled over. Most high don't want to hear that shit.
Some demons following your ass.
But I was listening to this shit because they wasn't nothing on. They got stuck on the channel. But this dude just, he's like, ever in your life, did you ever sit someone down and ask them, what has God done for you? Tell them about the love that God has shown you.
You need to write you a gratitude list.
I mean, what the fuck is this shit? Man, they had no scriptures. They give you no knowledge, no truth. Just have you ever told anybody about the love of Jesus? What the fuck?
Right.
That's
so inspirational.
You ever heard of Benny Hinn's or something like that?
Oh, Benny, oh, man. He got caught for fraud.
Yeah. I think, you see the videos when he was like.
They proved that all those healings he did were fake. Hmm. He's made millions. What's it, Benny Hinn, right?
Still yeah. Making money.
He's got goddamn heathen, ain't he?
Yeah, yeah.
He's making videos. Well, I think he had Jake.
Well, I mean, he's got, you know what I mean, East Indian. Yeah.
Benny Hinn.
Big old faggot.
No, but they actually proved that a lot of those healings he did was all fake. Well, you didn't have to tell me. I knew this shit was fake. But he packing goddamn stadiums and shit. Man, he got thousands of people in the seats. All falling for that. I'm glad they fell for it.
He had his fucking jacket. He was stopping people with a jacket. They was falling over.
Yeah, the people walk by, he smack them like, pow! Get healed in the name of Jesus.
Like your homie Marjo.
Marjo just come. They just come up and grab you by the head and go, in the name of Jesus.
That's some crazy shit.
Well, that shit is nuts.
Do some exorcisms like Bob Larson.
Oh, like Bob Larson?
They eat it up.
Yeah, people eat that shit up.
You can actually have an exorcism done online by Bob Larson. You can pay him some money.
Yeah, you got to pay him money, of
course. He'll do it over the computer.
Yeah, he can exorcise you through the computer. How convenient. Oh, going to see these preachers. That ain't Bible study. That is not a Bible lesson. That's a goddamn three-ring circus.
That's a good way to get some pussy.
That's a carnival.
You know?
No. You better teach that shit they teaching. Don't teach them no truth because you get no pussy.
None.
Don't hit no scriptures because if you start hitting scriptures in a church, you get no pussy.
None.
If you start reading scriptures in a church, they might call the cops on you.
You can make up your own scriptures. They'd be down with that.
Yeah, if you did that, then maybe, yeah. Then I could see that. Then they might let you in.
I got a scripture, Romans 4:16-18. For they that are such serve not our Lord Yahweh Shai, the anointed, but their own belly.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, because these people... These people in these churches are a joke. Go ahead.
But their own belly, and by good words and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple.
And people say that we're in a cult. Like, you guys are cult members. Like, what the fuck about the people in these churches? These motherfuckers is crazy. They crazy as hell. They calling us cult members.
Yeah.
Man, they... giving all that money to these preachers. Preacher ain't teaching shit.
Remember that one time the pastor wrote his name and number down on one of his tithes envelope and gave it to us?
Yes.
Someone gave him like $730 in that envelope.
Yeah, just on one. That's just one envelope. That was the Lord giving us a glimpse. And that was a little raggedy church. A little hole in the wall.
Before I came into the church. You know, remember when T.D. Jakes came to Columbus?
Oh, shit, that fat faggot.
When I used to live on, when I first came, before I came to the church, I lived on 5th Avenue.
Yeah.
We went to that church. And nigga, he was like, I need, like, he pretty much asked the people for $1,000. And like, a couple people left there gave him $1,000.
Damn.
His fat ass up there.
Damn.
I was like, what the fuck, man?
That's crazy. I wish I was there, though.
Hey,
I
would
love to see it, though, you know.
I wish I was in the church at that time.
Yeah.
They give this con man all their money, but they'd never give real men of the Lord shit. They give you a hard way to go.
Remember that one time that drunk dude gave us $20?
He gave us $50. That was years ago.
Oh, what about your one dude?